While I'm waiting, I will serve you. While I'm waiting, I will worship. स्वागत करते हैं और विनती करते हैं कि आज का जो हमारा वर्शिप सेशन है, हम सब कोई के लिए एक आशीष हो और वी विल ऑल रिसीव गॉड्स ब्लेसिंग्स फ्रॉम आवर वर्शिप दिस इवनिंग। हम सबको एक बार फिर से आप लोगों का स्वागत करते हैं और हम बहुत खुश हैं कि इतने सारे लोग आज हमारे वर्शिप में ज्वाइन किए हैं अलग अलग जगह से। एंड सबसे पहले वी वुड लाइक टू थैंक डॉक्टर मेलविन राव फॉर होस्टिंग and for the little intro with the nice meditational music that you help us set the mood for our worship, leaving all the cares and worries of this week that we have been through. It just sets a nice calm mood for us to enter into God's holy Sabbath and to worship him in truth and in spirit. And so as the others keep joining us, we want to keep welcoming you to our Vespers worship service this evening. So, फिर से हम ईश्वर मसीह के नाम से आप सबको इस सुंदर सबत का शुरुआत में स्वागत करते हैं। We'd like to welcome you with these verses from Psalm, book of Psalms 8 and verses 1, 3, and 4. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. Who has set thy glory above the heavens? When I consider thy heavens, the works of thy fingers, the moon and the stars which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? So such a wonderful thought that God is mindful of us no matter what situations we are in. Even though we call his name or we do not call his name, He is there for us. So how excellent is your name, O Lord, on this earth. So let us praise him and thank him for his goodness and for his mercies. Let's begin our service today. Before we begin, let's have a word of prayer. And I will ask Mr. David Chan to please come over and just open us with a prayer.
All right. So let's pray. Our Lord and our God, Heavenly Father, thou art have given us the Sabbath day. We thank you. We praise you. We just, Lord, express our thankfulness and gratitude to thee for the very life that we live, for the excellent health thou gives to us, and for your daily provisions provided to us. Bless our worship session this evening. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much. So as we progress, we have, song service by the Ghachila boys. So we want to welcome the Ghachila boys, our young and budding rising stars, to lead us in worship songs. Okay, over to you all.
Good evening, everybody, and happy Sabbath to all. I welcome you all in the song service. And to start the song service, we'll sing a few songs. And our first song will be Purify My Heart.
Purify my heart, let me be as gold and precious silver. Purify my heart, let me be as gold, your gold, refined as fire. My heart's one desire is to be holy, apart for you, Lord. I choose to be holy, set apart for you, my master, ready to do your will. to do your will. Ready to do your will.
Sing, Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross, my debts to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debts to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high.
We'll sing Tum Sa Koi Nahi.
Tum Sa Koi Nahi. Tum Sa Kahi Nahi. Ab Hai Pura Yakin. Tum Sa Koi Nahi. Tum Sa Koi nahi, tum sa kahi nahi. Ab hai pura yakin, tum sa koi nahi. Yeshu Masih, oh mahima teri gaaye aasma, gaaye ye zameen. Yeshu Masih, अंधेरों में तू रोशनी, रास्ता भी है, तू है जान कुछ कमी है, तेरा ही नाम जिंदगी है, अंधेरों में तू रोशनी है, तू ही मंजिल भी है, तू है जहाँ न कुछ कमी है, तेरा ही नाम जिंदगी है, हाले
participating in the song service.
Thank you, Kenny, and your team for leading us in the worship with songs and praises. Those songs are always very touching, and we enjoy worshiping Lord with all these nice songs. So at this time, we would like to invite Mrs. Tete to offer the prayer. Hum is waqt Mrs. Tete ko aamintrit karte hain. हमें
भी में अगुवाई करें। चलिए हम लोग प्रार्थना करेंगे। हे दयालु ईश्वर पिता, हम तेरा धन्यवाद करते हैं। जितने भी हम लोग एक झुंड हो करके प्रभु तेरा नाम लेने के लिए इकट्ठा हुए हैं, तब हमको तेरा आशीष दयालु ईश्वर पिता। हम लोग पूरे सप्ताह भर हम लोग भला चंगा थे, आज सबक के आरंभ में हम लोग इकट्ठा हुए हैं पिता। हम सभी को तेरा आशीष, तेरा पवित्र वचनों को सुनने और समझने और सीखने के लिए प्रभु हम सब इकट्ठा हुए हैं। दयालु ईश्वर पिता, दयावंत है, हर कोई के साथ में रहा और भला चंगा रह करके प्रभु तेरा धन्यवाद देने के लिए इकट्ठा हुए हैं। और जो कोई बीमार दुख तकलीफ में है प्रभु, लोग नहीं आ सके हैं, उनके लिए भी प्रार्थना करते हैं पिता। लोग को भी तेरा आशीष हो और भला चंगा हो करते पिता, तेरे नाम लेने के लिए। हे दयालु ईश्वर पिता, कितना महान है हम सबों प्रभु, और तेरे पवित्र वचनों को एक दूसरा को भी बतलाने के लिए योग्य हो सके। दयालु ईश्वर पिता, धन्यवाद देते हैं तूने हम सबों को, हर एक कोई को तेरा पवित्र वचन सिखा, ताकि हम विश्वास के द्वारा तेरे पवित्र इच्छा के अनुसार चलने सके। बुजुर्ग लोग तेरे पास उपस्थित हुए हैं प्रभु, उन लोग को भी आशीष दे, ताकि तेरे पवित्र इच्छा के अनुसार चलने सके और उसे बने रहने सके, और तेरा ही महिमा स्तुति करते हुए अपना जीवन यापन कर सके प्रभु, और अपने जीवन को तेरे हाथ में सौंप सके। दयालु ईश्वर तू महान है, दयालु है, प्रत्येक के साथ हो, और जो जो कोई नहीं आए हैं प्रभु, उन सबों को भी ऐसे अवसर दे, ताकि तेरे करीब आकर के तेरा नाम बनाम लेकर के तेरा महिमा आगे बढ़ाते ले चलेंगे। तेरा वचन जहाँ कहीं भी नहीं पहुंचा है प्रभु, वहां भी पहुंचा सकेंगे। स्वर्गीय महान प्रभु, तने मुने बच्चे तेरे करीब हैं, उन लोग को भी तेरे हाथ में सौंपते हैं प्रभु, उनको पढ़ाई लिखाई में उनकी अगुवाई कर, और एक दिन पढ़ लिख करके प्रभु तेरे पवित्र वचनों को जहाँ कहीं भी नहीं पहुंच पाया है तेरा पवित्र वचन वहां तक लोग पहुंचा सकेंगे। तेरा आशीष के द्वारा प्रत्येक बच्चे तेरा महिमा के लिए एक झुंड हो सके। दयालु ईश्वर पिता, बुजुर्ग लोग कितने ही परिस्थिति में पड़े हुए हैं प्रभु, बीमार दुख तकलीफ में है, घर में है, अस्पताल में है, जहाँ कहीं भी है प्रभु, उनको भी तेरा वचन पहुंच सके और तेरा महिमा होने के लिए वो लोग भी स्मरण करते हुए प्रभु भला चंगा हो करके एक दिन तेरे करीब आ सके और तेरा महिमा प्रकट कर सके। हे दयालु ईश्वर पिता, हम संसारिक लोगों के बीच में है प्रभु, और संसारिक लोग साथ रहते हुए उसके साथ मिलजुल के रह करके भी प्रभु उन लोग को हम तेरा वचनों को सिखाते हैं, उनके मन आत्मा में प्रभु बस जा और उनको तेरे अगुवाई के द्वारा तेरा वचनों को ग्रहण कर सके। स्वर्गीय महान प्रभु तो दयालु और प्रेमी पिता प्रत्येक के साथ में है, और दूर दरार में जहीं भी हो हमारे इसी कुटुम भाई बंधु हमारे कलिसिया के लोग हैं सबों को प्रभु तो तेरा आशीष के द्वारा भला चंगा साकुशल रह करके तेरे महिमा के लिए एक झोंक होने सके। हे दयालु ईश्वर पिता, तू महान है और हर एक मन आत्मा में तू बास कर और तेरा महिमा बारंबार होने सके। अभी कोरोना के समय में हर एक शरीर में दुख तकलीफ है प्रभु, संकट है, विपत है प्रभु, अरे कोई कितने ही लोग मर मिट जा रहे हैं पिता, तो हम सबों को आप तक अपने दया रूपी हाथों से छाया किया है, और अब तक हम तेरे महिमा के लिए हम इकट्ठा हो सकते हैं। स्वर्गीय महान प्रभु, हम सब पापियों को पापों से हमें अपने लहू के द्वारा हम सबों को छुड़ा ले पिता, और अभी लेंट काल और कलिसिया में अभी लेंट काल का स्मरण करते हुए उपवास कर मना रहे हैं पिता, और भला शुक्रवार मनते हुए लोग तेरा महिमा प्रकट करते हैं। हे प्रभु, आप ऐसे शास्त्र में भी नमूना दिखाए हैं कि अपने लोगों बहा करके अपने प्राण को क्रूस में अपना दे करके हम सबों को रक्षा किया है, रखवाली किया है प्रभु। हम अपना तेरा नमूना हम प्रकट नहीं कर पाते हैं, ताओ भी है दयालु ईश्वर पिता, हम सबों को अब तक भला चंगा रखे हैं। हम सारे जुम में जुटे हुए जितने भी लोग हैं सदस्य हैं प्रभु, सबों को तेरा आशीष आज का होने पाए। और क्या मांगे प्रभु, मांगना बहुत है, मांगने से पहले सब कुछ जानते हैं पिता, थोड़े ही मांगे हैं प्रभु, इस विनती पर तेरा आशीष हो, आमीन।
हम मिसेस टेटे को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देते हैं सुंदर प्रार्थना के लिए, और हम अभी आगे बढ़ते हैं। इस वक्त हमारे बीच में मिस्टर ग्लैडविन टुडू हैं, जो इस समय बाइबल क्विज लेंगे। सो वी लाइक टू इनवाइट मिस्टर ग्लैडविन टुडू टू एट दिस टाइम टू कंडक्ट द क्विज फॉर अस।
एंड गुड इवनिंग एंड हैप्पी सैबथ टू ऑल। I think you can hear me. There's a lot of noise going around. Work is going on, so I've come to the bedroom so that I can escape some sound. Hopefully, you can hear. And I'll be sharing my screen. Okay, as you know, today we'll be doing Numbers chapter 4 through 6 and 7, 9, 4, 5, 8, 6, 8. Okay, I think we're good to go. Here comes the first question. the charge of the service of families of the son of Gershom was under the hand of your options, Eleazar, Ithamar, Aaron, Moses. Ithamar is the right answer. Seven of you got correct. And it's found in Numbers 4:28. Let's see the scoreboard. Kenny Masters is off the blocks with 921 points, followed by LP and Stels. Next question. True false for double. The number of men for service in the tabernacle, their age was between 20 to 50. Okay, the answer is false. It is 30 to 50. And it's found in Numbers 4:23, 30, 35, 39, 47. Okay, ZZZ has leapfrogged to second place. Kenny Master maintains his lead. Next question. Upon the table of showbread was spread a dash cloth, purple, scarlet, blue, white. Okay, the answer is blue, found in Numbers 4:7. Okay, Stels has leapfrogged to first position, followed by Delano, and Shania brings up the third position. Next question is question number 4. The total men that were numbered to do service in the ministry and the service of the burden of the tabernacle were 2750, 2630, 3200, none of these. Okay, the answer is none of these. It is 8580, and only five of you have got correct. Kenny Master reclaims his top position. ZZ Stels bring up the second and third position. The next question. Okay, double points again. The priest shall write the curses in a book and blot them out with bitter water. Okay, the answer is true and found in Numbers 5:23. Except one, all of you have got correct. Okay, the first three positions remain the same. Going on to the sixth question. Recompense a man's trespass with the principal was added unto it, dash, 1/10, 1/5. Okay, it's 1/5, found in Numbers 5:7. Six of you got correct. Okay, ZZ is on top again. Delano is second. Kenny Masters goes down to third position. The next question. On which day a person with the vow of Nazareth brings two turtles or two young pigeons to the priest? 7th, 8th, 10th, 14th. Okay, it's 8th day and it's found in Numbers 6:10. Let's see, only three of you got correct. And the top three positions remain the same. The next question, true or false? A Nazarite during the days of separation shall eat the things made from the vine tree, from the kernel of husks. Jimmy. It's false. Let's see. Okay, the scoreboard remains the same. The leaders, top three, remain the same. The second last question coming up. The Nazarite shall shave the head of his separation and take the hair and put it in the fire, which is a sacrifice of dash. Jealousy offering, wave offering, trespass offering, peace offering. It's peace offering. Only two of you got correct. Okay, we have new leader Delano on top right now, followed by ZZZ and Kenny Masters. The final question, double points. Who took down the covering of the veil and cover the Ark of Testimony with it? Moses, Aaron and sons, Kohathites, Gershomites. Okay, Aaron and his sons. Okay, there was a lot to gain. Let's see what's the final standing. Okay, in third position is Stels, 6 out of 10. Second position is Kenny Masters. And the winners today, Delano, 8 out of 10, but then they have 9,673. And the runners-up, Prit, and the fifth position is ZZZ. Congratulations to all the winners. May you continue to read God's word. And over to Dolly Didi.
Thank you so much, Gladwin, for that very interesting quiz. A lot of things we get to learn week after week. And I hope it is enriching our Bible knowledge, especially in the ancient times with the sacrificial systems. So congratulations, the winners. Keep working, keep reading, and keep doing your best. All right. So it is time for our special song, and we invite the Ghachila group to present a special song for us, to bless our heart with a special song. इस समय हम धन्यवाद देते हैं ग्लैडविन टुडू को. बहुत अच्छी तरीके से उन्होंने बाइबल क्विज किया. और इस समय हमारे बीच में स्पेशल सॉन्ग गाने आ रहे हैं घाचीला ग्रुप. और हम देख रहे हैं बाबू, शनाया एंड ग्रुप आर कमिंग फॉरवर्ड. सो वी गिव दिस टाइम टू देम. यस,
हैप्पी साबत एवरीबॉडी. सबको एक हैप्पी साबत. और हम लोग जो गीत प्रस्तुत करने वाले हैं वो गीत सब कोई जानते हैं या नहीं जानते हैं मुझको नहीं पता, लेकिन अगर जानते हैं तो हमारे साथ गुनगुना सकते हैं. जिंदगी मेरी बदल गई जब से मसीह को पाया है.
जिंदगी मेरी बदल गई जब से मसीह को पाया है. खिल गई है गलियां नई, यीशु बाहर लाया है. जिंदगी मेरी पाया है, खिल गई है कलियां नई, यीशु बाहर लाया है. जीवन है क्या, पल हो पल का, किसने जाना होगा कल क्या. जीवन है क्या, पल हो पल किसने जाना होगा कल क्या. घड़ियां सुनहरी फिर ना लौटेगी, घड़ियां सुनहरी फिर ना करेगा कदम डगमगाए हाथ थामेगा भटके हुओं को राह दिखाने भटके हुओं को राह दिखाने इस धरती पर वो आया है जिंदगी मेरी से दे दो हमको जीवन की रोटी अमृत जल को कैसे भरपूरी से दे दो हमको लहू बहाकर पाप हमारे लहू बहाकर पाप हमारे प्यारे प्रभु ने
बहुत धन्यवाद देते हैं बहुत सुंदर गीत के लिए यह हमारा ऑल टाइम फेवरेट सॉन्ग है सो थैंक यू मामू मामी बाबू बबली शनाया और सूजी आप लोगों ने बहुत अच्छी तरीके से इस गाने को पेश किया एंड फॉर ब्लेसिंग आवर हार्ट सो थैंक यू वेरी मच नाउ इट इज टाइम फॉर अस टू हियर द मैसेज फ्रॉम द लॉर्ड एंड टू ब्रिंग अ मैसेज टू अस इज नन अदर देन आवर डियर अंकल मनिक किस्कु joining us from Vellore. So over to Uncle Manik Kisku. We are so glad that you can join our worship this evening with your family. And we would like to welcome you and to give you this time to share God's message with us. Uncle Manik Kisku.
On the onset, I want to welcome you all to the Sabbath evening. Many of us enjoy this Sabbath evening earlier than the others, some much later. But we are thankful. People in Arabia, they have, they are perhaps 3 hours later than us. And this evening, I would like to tell a story of a girl, 10-year-old. I would call her Anna. And she tells a story. She liked to tell, hear stories, and they used to have a time when they would gather around home, and father would tell the story, and he would tell everybody a story. And during this time, he would often would bring some sort of gift. So they used to call this a shoot time. And it was the most pleasant time because this is the time father would bring out something new. And they wanted to listen to news of Arabia because they didn't have any other access. Friends were very far away. And so that local news would be of help. And so one day, father brought a radio. They were very excited. They all jumped around and switched it off, switched it on. And they were very, very happy. And so they had they had nice time of having a this particular story time. She thanked everybody. She had like Cinderella almost forgot to thank her father. She went and gave a big hair hug, and she kissed him all over the face, just like a small puppy would do. And then she would tell father that how she was happy. Even her prayer must have been something like Elijah, the prophet of old. I once remember a story of fight between the hands, the finger of the hand. And the story goes like this. The thumb said, "Stop, all of you fellas. I'm the biggest of all. Shut up." Then the moderator says, "Okay, your turn is over. Now this one, what? This is a pointing finger. I point everyone to the letters on the book, and I am the greatest." Then the third fellow, this middle fellow, got very upset. I said, "What the dickens? You are telling me that you are the highest? You stand between me?" And there goes this chap. And so he gets, okay, let's keep you on the side. Then this one, "Master, without me, nobody can have a family life. See, this is called ring finger, and I am the ring finger." The last fellow said, okay, I agreed. "But fold your hand. I am the first." Even when Elijah prayed, God had to bow down on the seventh prayer. He answered by opening the sky, and rain came. So they were so the story goes that prayer is something that we can have bring heaven down. We have so many definitions, so many illustration given in the spirit of prophecy, the desire of vision. I have number of them that I would keep it for next time when I would relate them. But I would like to give certain illustration. There's during some time last decades, there was a ethnic war between two tribes, Hutu and Tutsi, in Uganda. They were bitter enemies. They started killing each other. Before the war came, even the Tutu pastors would go and preach to the Hutu audience, and the vice versa. They were happy. But when the war came, the ugliness in them came out, surfaced. Even the pastors, they started abusing the member. So much so, some of the pastors were killed. In one occasion, what happened was a pastor was killed, and they had a church. In the church, they had a baptistry. And in the baptistry, there was a place. So when the war started, these ladies, they just all came inside. And when they came inside, and they shut the door. But the enemies, they knew where these people were. So they came and they pushed the door open, and in they went, and they started hacking them this way, that way, and they left. One lady, she was hacked unfortunately, the man who wanted to hack her scalp, he managed to remove the scalp, and so the scalp fell down. And she fell among the dead. She was bleeding profusely, but somehow the bleeding did not kill her. After 3 days, the group, NGO group, came to pick up and do the last ceremony for them and bury them and all. They found this lady hanging between life and death. And then they saw her one finger up, and it was sort of hanging like this. It was dangling like this. When the finger was dangling, flies did come, but she was there. When the NGO came, they noticed that this lady is sort of away. They listened to her heartbeat, and lo, there was a faint heartbeat. So they immediately got her in the ambulance, took her to the hospital, revived her. And when 3-4 months later, they put her in the van and took her home. At home, she took 4-5 months time to recover fully. And when she recovered, her hand was sort of crooked because time has lapsed and the bone had already set and it was crooked. And nonetheless, it was a functional hand. She could do everything. On one day, she was washing her clothes, and after she has washed, she was hanging up on the clothesline, when suddenly she noticed a person coming toward her. Now, that person was limping. She said, first, her impulse was to run because she recognized that this particular person was the one who tried to kill her. And instead of chopping her head, he, in a hurry, he removed her scalp. She wanted to run, but she was so transfixed that she remained there. And when she remained there, this man came and fell down at his feet. He said, "Madam, I'm so sorry. Forgive me." He couldn't say more than that. He kept on repeating, forgive me, man, forgive me. Accept me like your own son. I am your son. I'm no longer that person who killed your husband, who came to kill you. But now I'm coming as a son. Please accept. Many of the stories that we have heard during the wartime, God worked a miracle in her heart. She says, she couldn't say anything but said, "I do forgive you. I do forgive you. You are my son. And now you come along with me to my home. Live with me. Stay with me. And be my son." This part of the story, I don't remember much, but one thing I remember, that this particular man perhaps went to complete his high schooling, because those days people used to study much. Completed his high school and the universities, went to the denominational college and prepared for a denominational law. Such was the power of faith. All because this lady, she always called her neighbors every evening, every morning and noontime if possible. They gathered at her home, prayed, even after the war was over. Now, he is the most powerful preacher. He has seen his life transformed. When people challenge, hey, you are a hoax man, he says, okay, I am hoax, see my life. It's an example that I would say, if I have an orange and I eat, finish eating, wash my hand, and I'll ask you, how does the mango, that particular orange taste? You would turn around and say, you fool, you ate it, and you are asking me to tell you the taste? Is it ridiculous? It's foolishness on your part. So this man would say, well, so is my life. I have experienced Christ. He has changed me. He has changed my life. I was a killer. I was a, before I became a Christian, before I accepted Christ, I was anything but a good person. And now Christ has changed me. It's a marvelous. It's only I can say. All we need to do is to listen to his testimony. Because he was changed because of the prayer. Many of us, prayer, how far does our prayer go up? Prayers do go up. All of us have experience. I can tell number of stories. You can tell number of stories. Everybody has a story of his or her own. Just as Diana had a story, so also. I remember a pastor by name Dr. Ravi Zakaria. Many of you may have heard his name. He was one of the most powerful preachers I have heard. I always listen to him. He passed away recently, but his story remains. One of the stories was his parents depended on him. He was at the age of 17, he almost committed suicide in Delhi, but for some reason God had planned to took him out. He studied BCom, Masters, he got married, he went to Toronto, and there he got married in Toronto, and his wife was a God-fearing. They would pray that, God, please help us to find a girl for our older brother. By the way, Ravi Zakaria's brother was an engineer, software engineer. And he would, when time came for marriage, he goes to father and mother, tell them, Mama and Papa, please find me a bride. Now, I have my personal experience of getting bride. When I went to Ranchi to find a bride for my son, I was sweating because I was cornered. And they said, now, look here, you need to find a bride. I said, how? My wife immediately sent a message, you must agree. Similarly, this man comes, and he did not know which one to choose, so he stands at the airplane, lands in Bombay, and he was at the entrance of the airplane, and he was holding a garland. He did not know who he is going to garland, but he has been praying, Father, find me a girl who I would put garland, and she would be my wife. Out in the tarmac was a girl, and she was praying, God, help me to choose a man whom I will marry. Not the right one, not the center one, not the this is left one, but you choose. He comes down, and not realizing what was happening, he put the garland on the right girl. They were married. Till today, they are very happy. This is how God works in our heart. Prayer. How much of prayer do we say? We have examples of so many in the Bible. We have examples like David. He prayed when he was in trouble. We have find it in Psalms chapter 51. He prayed the greatest prayer, King Solomon, before his apostasy, before women came and took his heart away. He prayed, God, when I pray toward Jerusalem with my hand lifted up, you will hear me and heal the land. What does that land mean to us today? It means everything. Personal, health, wealth, education, our status, name, we have almost everything in our land. Land means how we interact with others. Solomon fell down, but he never left his ways with God before he fell down. But so many came, especially when the wife from others came, Ethiopia and other places, they led his heart away from him. So, all because he forgot to pray. And when we pray toward Jerusalem, what will? What is our Jerusalem? Jerusalem is our new Jerusalem, heaven. When we lift up our hand and pray, thank you, God. Thank you for everything. My family, my children, my parents, all of them are your property, please take care. Dr. Zakaria tells another story which I really like to tell. During the Second World War time, students were, many young people were drafted to army. George, let's call him, he was also the right age to be drafted into the army. He was about to be married. He was very much interested in getting married. He really was in love with his fiance. Let's call her Anna by name. They were in head over heel in love. And Wednesday was the date that they decided to get married. But on Sunday, the army officer called him. Now, buddy, you better pack up. Let's go to the army station. he couldn't open his mouth, packed up, said goodbye to this Anna and mother. And he would send letter. He would write letter every day. First, in the beginning, two letters would come, three letters would come. Slowly the letters started drilling down, one letter, and then finally no letter. And mother got discouraged and said, probably we do not know what can happen in the war. He must be killed or must be somewhere where he is unable to contact us. But this did not quench the longing of that girl, Helen, we call her. Helen. So, what to do? So, she decided to build a small altar and put George's photo there, and he would look at it and think that he is very near to me. This went on for quite some time. The letters started dwindling down, and no letter. No. Mother told her probably he must have gone to some other place. Or why don't others are telling me, get your daughter married to somebody. But the girls were so defiant. I will die unmarried, but I will not get married to anybody, whoever, whatever comes. So they have a two-story building, like in West, where my son is in UK. They have a two-story, three-story building. Usually the front room will be a place where the visitors would come stay there, or the other side there will be a kitchen or washroom or something. The first room where usually they would have the bedroom or sleep. So this girl had converted an altar-like thing and put the photo of George in front. She would go and cry and cry and sob and sob and sob for a long time. And when she is tired, her eyes puffy, she would come back. So this was happening almost every day. And one day, she decided to go up. Remember, I told that they were ready to get married. She took the dress, wedding dress, she put her crown, the veil over, looked so nice. But she couldn't see beyond the veil what she was wearing. And so she climbed up and she was placed it, and she was crying and crying. All of a sudden, mother hears a sound. Tap, 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 crack, tap, crack. Mother looks at her. She was under the impression George is nowhere around here. And, George, it's you? Yes, yes, mother. Please keep quiet. Where is Anna? Oh, she's upstairs. Keep quiet. Okay. Just let me go and see. So he climbs up the steps, tuck, 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 and came to the floor. And there, he opened the door slowly, and peeps in, and there she is crying. So he goes slowly, and then he holds her by the shoulder. Like Mary on the day of resurrection, the tears in her eyes could not recognize the Savior. This girl, she was so absorbed in sobbing, and forgot the reality. She just kept sobbing. Then she turned around. Then she realized, hugged him, and she lifted her up, put her in the arm, and said, "George, it's you." When he said, "George, it's you," she was beyond the excitement. How it will be ours when Christ comes, when we are all church dressed up like a bride. We are told we are bride, 10 brides, virgin bride. The Bible has number of examples where brides are mentioned. And when Jesus comes and he wants us, he wants to lift us up, take us to heaven. And if you are not ready, sorry, but if you are ready, he lifts us up into the air, and where in the midst of air, he says, "Let's go home," and we will be at in home, not in the second resurrection, but in the last resurrection, when everyone will be in heaven praising God. So thank you very much. Let us encourage our young people, our not so young people, so old people, not so old people, these virtues of living a prayerful life. We do not know when Christ will come. And when he comes, he will come to take his people home. May God bless you.
Thank you very much, Uncle Kiskum, Manik Kiskum. It was so nice to hear you after a long time, and for the message that you gave us, the message of hope, the message of prayer, and I think you began with a message of forgiveness. And it is so much, so many important lessons that we can learn from this message that we can apply to our hearts. And it is, we are living in a time that we need to be very close to God, and in the worldly life that we have today, we need to walk a closer walk with God. So thank you very much for the timely message. हम अंकल मनी किस्कू को बहुत धन्यवाद देते हैं. उन्होंने हमारे बीच में बहुत सुंदर वचन पेश किया और परमेश्वर के वचन से हमें ये बताया, तीन चीज हमें बताया. पहला चीज तो जो हमें एक कहानी बताए थे हुट्सी और टुट्सी और हुटूस के बारे में, जो युगांडा के जो ट्राइब थे वो कैसे एक दूसरे के दुश्मन बन गए, एक दूसरे को मार डाले, और एडवेंटिस्ट और क्रिश्चियन होने के बावजूद भी वो एक दूसरे को छोड़े नहीं. पर एक उन्होंने बताया इंसिडेंट की, जहाँ पे एक जवान लड़का ने एक औरत को मारने की कोशिश की, पर उसकी जिंदगी बच गई थी. और बहुत साल के बाद जब उन्होंने एक दूसरे के आमने सामने आए, वो ठीक हो गई, उसने ईश्वर ने उसे बचा लिया. और इस महिला ने उस यंग पर्सन जो था, जो उसके सामने आ खड़ा हुआ और उसको वो पहचानी कि ये उसको मारने चाहता था, पर उसने उसको माफ किया और उसको अपने घर बुलाया और अपने साथ रखा. तो हम देखते हैं कि फॉरगिवनेस, जो माफी देना, ईश्वर का काम है. अगर हम उसे अलाउ करते हैं कि पवित्र आत्मा हमारे हृदय को में जब आते हैं, तो हमें ये देते हैं कि हम दूसरों को प्यार करें और उनको माफी दे, चाहे वो जो भी हमें दुख तकलीफ पहुंचाए हैं. तो ये बहुत सुंदर एक वचन, पहला कहानी जो हमें बताया था. और दूसरा कहानी उन्होंने हमें प्रेयर के बारे में बताया कि किस तरह से प्रेयर से हम जो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट डिसीशंस जो हम लेने चाहते हैं, कभी कभी हमें बहुत कंफ्यूजन होता है कि हमारा राइट डिसीशन, सही और गलत के बारे में समझ में नहीं आता. पर हम जब प्रार्थना करते हैं, विनती करते हैं, तो हम उसे समझ पाते हैं. और इस तरह से उन्होंने हमें एक कहानी बताया अपना बेटा के बारे में, जब उन्हें एक चुनना था, अपना लाइफ पार्टनर चुनना था, तो किस तरह से ये प्रेयर के द्वारा उसने सही और सही चॉइस किया और इस जिस जो अभी उसकी जो पत्नी है जो उसको चुना ईश्वर के द्वारा उसने उस चॉइस को कर पाया और वो मुमकिन था। तो ये दूसरा कहानी हमें बताया। और तीसरा कहानी हमें बताया थे कि जो जो यंग कपल थे जो एक दूसरे को प्यार करते थे और शादी करने वाले थे, तो उस वक्त जो आदमी था वो चला गया वॉर में और जो वहाँ पे हो रहा था जो वॉर्स हो रहे थे, लड़ाई चल रहे थे, युद्ध चल रहे थे, उसमें उसे जाना पड़ा और ये लड़की अकेले रह गई घर में। और बहुत दिन बीत गया और माँ बाप और लोग भी कहने लगे कि शादी कर लो, शादी कर लो, इसके लिए क्यों इंतजार कर रहे हो। पर एक दिन ऐसा हुआ कि वो वापस आया, जॉर्ज जिसका नाम था वो वापस आया और वो एना से मिला और वो दोनों बहुत खुश हुए। तो ये बताते कि ईश्वर मसीह, यीशु मसीह भी हमारे लिए मतलब कि जगह जो तैयार किया है हमारे साथ ईश्वर स्वर्ग में ले जाने चाहता है, पर हम इंतजार कर रहे हैं उस घड़ी के लिए, उस पल के लिए। और जब इंतजार कर रहे हैं हमें उस हमें ईश्वर पर भरोसा करना चाहिए और हमें फेथफुल रहना चाहिए उसके आने तक। तो ये जो तीन कहानी और तीन लेसन हमें समझने को मिला है, हम बहुत धन्यवाद देते हैं अंकल किसको के लिए। माफ करना, माफी देना पहली बात, दूसरी बात प्रेयर पर भरोसा करना, प्रार्थना पर भरोसा करना, और तीसरी बात हम जो बाग राह देख रहे हैं यीशु मसीह का दूसरे आगमन के लिए कि हम किस तरह से अपने आप को उनके हाथों में सौंप दे, किस तरह से हम फेथफुल होकर के उस दिन के लिए इंतजार करें और हम अपना कदम इधर से उधर ना भटके पर ईश्वर के बताए हुए रास्ते में चलते रहें। सो थैंक यू वेरी मच। आई जस्ट कैप्चर इट फॉर द हिंदी स्पीकिंग पीपल इन हिंदी। सो आई होप ऑल ऑफ अस वर ब्लेस्ड। हम आशा करते हैं कि इस वचन से हम सबको आशीष मिले। और इस सभा को हम अंत करने के लिए इस समय हम निमंत्रित करते हैं कि हमारे बीच अभी एक स्पेशल सॉन्ग होगा जो खुंटी के ग्रुप वाले हमारे सामने पेश करेंगे। तो रानी, रश्मि और ग्रुप, आर यू ऑल रेडी? तुम लोग तैयार हो? तो इस समय हम उनको समय देते हैं स्पेशल सॉन्ग के लिए।
धन्यवाद देते हैं दीदी को जो आपने हमें समझ दिया है और सबको हैप्पी साबत। और आइए हम लोग सबको ही मिलके परमेश्वर की स्तुति, महिमा, धन्यवाद अपने हृदय से, अपने मन से, सारे दिल से करेंगे। तो हम लोग आइए परमेश्वर का धन्यवाद सब मिलके करते हैं। सारे दिल से, सारे मन से यीशु को हम प्यार करें, जिसने किया सबका उद्धार, मसीह को हम प्यार करें। यीशु बिना जीवन हमारा ईशु हमारा जीवन दा, ईशु हमारा कान दा। सारे दिल से, सारे मन से ईशु को हम प्यार करें, जिसने किया सबका उद्धार, मसीह को हम प्यार करें। यीशु बिना जीवन हमारा बेकरार, यीशु हमारा जीवन दा, यीशु हमारा प्राण दा। सारे मन से, सारे मन से यीशु को हम प्यार करें, जिसने किया सबका उद्धार, मसीह को हम प्यार करें। यीशु बिना जिसने किया सबका उद्धार, मसीह को हम प्यार करें। यीशु बिना दिल में ना है, है उमंग, है उमंग, है उमंग। यीशु है हमारा जीवन धारा, यीशु है हमारा प्राण निवास। सारे दिल से, सारे मन से यीशु को हम प्यार हैं। जिसने किया सबका उद्धार, मसीह को हम प्यार करें। सारे दिल से, सारे मन से यीशु को हम प्यार करें। जिसने किया सबका उद्धार, मसीह को हम प्यार करें।
थैंक यू रानी। रानी, रश्मि, असरिता मामी और रोशन को हम बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देते हैं उस सुंदर गीत के लिए, और बहुत सुंदर वचन उस गीत से हमें सुनने को मिला है। थैंक, वी लाइक टू थैंक रानी, रश्मि, रोशन एंड असरिता मामी फॉर द ब्यूटिफुल सॉन्ग। The meaning of the song was Jesus is a life giver, he is a way maker, and we want to love him with all our heart, with all our might, and with all our soul. So thank you very much for that beautiful message in song. And now we would like to close our worship with a closing prayer, and we'd like to invite Uncle Gamaliel to offer the closing prayer. Is samay hum sabha ko ant karte hain aur hum आमंत्रित करते हैं अंकल गमालियल टुड्डू को हमें प्रार्थना में अगुवाई करें और सभा को अंत करें। और हम रिक्वेस्ट करते हैं अंकल कि आप आई भी मौसी के लिए प्रार्थना करिए, जो इस वक्त वो ठीक तबीयत ठीक नहीं है, उनका सर्जरी होने वाला है या हो गया है हमें पता नहीं, पर हम उसे अपने प्रार्थना में याद करेंगे। अंकल गमालियल टुड्डू,
बताइए। हम लोग प्रार्थना करेंगे। महान ईश्वर दयालु पिता, हम तुझे धन्यवाद देते हैं पूरा सप्ताह हम सबों की रक्षा रखवाले की और इस सुंदर सावत के शुरू में लाया है। पिता, हम धन्यवादित हैं कि तू यह शुभ अवसर दिया है। जगह जगह में बीमार महामारी होने के बावजूद भी हम अपने प्रियजन मिल करके हम लोग तेरी स्तुति और धन्यवाद का गीत गा सकते हैं। हम धन्यवादित हैं इस मौका के लिए कि हम आकर के हम तुझको पुकार सकते हैं, तुझसे प्रार्थना कर सकते हैं। इस समय जो वचन हमने सुना है पिता, कि तू कितना महान है, तू कितना दयालु है, तू कितना तुझ पर हम भरोसा कर सकते हैं। हम जानते हैं पिता हम कमजोर हैं, लेकिन तू महान है, तू शक्तिशाली है। जब कोई तेरे पास आते हैं और तुझको पुकारते हैं तो उनकी प्रार्थना को सुनता है। इस समय जो वचन हमने कहानी के द्वारा सुना पिता, हमें तो मदद और सहायता कर ताकि हम में भी वह प्रेम जागरूक कर, ताकि हम दूसरों को प्रेम करने सके। हम जानते हैं कि तू बहुत ही जल्दी आने वाला है अपने लोगों को ले जाने के लिए। तू ही हमें मदद और सहायता कर उस दिन के लिए तैयार होने के लिए। हम बात जो हैं पिता, इस समय हम प्रार्थना करते हैं मिसिस आईवी सोरेन के लिए। पिता बीमार है पिता, तू तो डॉक्टरों को डॉक्टर है, वैद्यों को वैद्य है। जो भी चिकित्सा का काम छानबीन करके करने जा रहे हैं पिता, उस पर तेरी आशीष हो। उसी प्रकार से हम याद करते हैं दूसरे दूसरे जगह में लोग बीमार हैं कोरोना से, तू उन सबों के संग हो पिता। तू उन्हें तो आशीष दे और उन्हें चंगाई दे। रात्रि आ गई है, हम इस रात्रि में हम अपने आप को तेरे हाथ में सौंपते हैं पिता, तू अपने स्वर्गदूतों को भेज ताकि वे हमारी रक्षा रखवाली करने सके, सुनिंद्रा शुभ विश्राम दे ताकि कल सुबह को उठकर फिर से हम तेरा धन्यवाद करने सके, हमारे पाप गुनाहों को तो क्षमा कर और तेरे राज के लिए हमें तैयार कर, हमें तो मौका दे ताकि आने वाला साबत शुरू में भी फिर से हम तेरे स्तुति और धन्यवाद करें। और क्या मांगेंगे, मांगने के पहले तो सब कुछ जानता है, इस विनती को हमने ख्रिस्त के नाम से मांगा है, कृपा का सुना घन कर।
I will serve you.